Nurses, some may argue that we are the backbone of our healthcare industry, but how can we take care of our nation if we don't take care of ourselves? My name is Frances Akubuilo, and I'm a director of patient care at a home health agency and also a student of the California State University Doctor of Nursing Practice Consortium. In my work environment, I supervise and manage a diverse group of clinicians at my agency, and majority of those are nurses. Of course, we are always striving to provide the best patient care possible. I do, however, acknowledge that at times, providing quality care could be costly to our own health as nurses and clinicians. I feel that is why I developed a passion for looking into the health of my staff and colleagues and figuring out ways to ensure that we can focus on our own health as well as our own patients. The nursing profession can be pretty tough and stressful, which is why I wasn't really surprised to discover that nurses were found to be unhealthier than the average American when looking at data reported by the American Nurses Association. It was pretty disheartening to actually see and visualize that statement, but it did light up something in me to help to change this data. I was able to work with the American Holistic Nurses Association on a Healthy Nurse, Healthy Nation initiative, which was created by the American Nurses Association to challenge nurses across America to improve their health by focusing on self-care. The Grand Challenge concept is great because nurses can be motivated to reach goals related to their health. Healthy Nurse, Healthy Nation creates a space where we as nurses can engage with each other and bring different ideas to the table that can increase our self-care practices. There are also monthly challenges that can help nurses make goals on a continuous basis, as well as a survey called the Health Risk Appraisal, available for nurses to complete on the website so they can assess their current health status. The questions on the survey focus on 5 domains, which are physical activity, nutrition, rest, quality of life, and safety. I specifically studied physical activity since that was one area in which we found nurses had increased challenges. The Department of Health and Human Services recommends at least 2 hours and 30 minutes of moderate to vigorous intensity workouts per week, in addition to muscle strengthening at least 2 times per week for adults. When researching the health risk appraisal stats from February 2017 to May 2019, I found that nurses were averaging 1 to 2 vigorous and muscle strengthening workouts per week, with majority nurses spending 0 to 15 minutes on each vigorous workout. This shows that we as nurses may need to work together to increase our physical activity levels to help decrease factors that contribute to nurses being unhealthy, like high obesity rates. The CDC reports the highest obesity rates in America include the Hispanic population at 47% and the African American population at 46.8%. Working on the engagement of nurses from various ethnic backgrounds may be significant in contributing to the Healthy Nurse, Healthy Nation movement. The CDC also reports the highest obesity rates including the middle-aged population at 42.8% for those between 40 to 59 years of age. This coincided with my research of the health risk appraisal, which showed middle-aged adults having the lowest activity levels. I was able to highlight several factors that were shown to have a positive correlation to increasing physical activity levels. These factors included wellness training, emotional support, pain management, and stress management. When working in a high-stress environment, nurses tend to get overwhelmed and turn to activities that can be harmful, like unhealthy eating and leading a sedentary lifestyle. Although these actions can be comforting after a stressful day, they do play a part in contributing to decreased physical activity and increased obesity rates. The HNA, as well as several studies and literature, suggest activities like health coaching and training in mindfulness, as well as practices like yoga, to help nurses get the emotional support they need while managing any stress or pain that develops as a result of our profession. The American Nurses Association also details the importance of having solutions like grand challenges, as well as periodic challenges that can help bring individuals together to collectively set goals and change behaviors for the better. I hope this information can help bring awareness to resources that nurses across the United States can utilize to learn more about how to focus on their own self-care and maintain healthy physical activity levels. Be sure to also check out my second video on enhancing self-care of nurses, where I go into more detail on suggested wellness training to help us nurses keep up with our physical activity.